presidential appointment. It was held on 12 August 2021, pursuant to Articles 47, 101, and 110 of the Constitution of the Republic of Zambia. And whereas Mr. Hakainde Hichilema was in the same election duly elected as President of the Republic of Zambia, now therefore the Honorable Justice of the Republic of Zambia, Mr. Francis Michael Sonda, State Council, invites the President-elect, Mr. Hakainde Hichilema, to step forward and take his oath of office before the Honorable Acting Chief Justice, the President-elect, sir.
Thank you. request the Secretary to the Government to perform his duties. The Secretary to the Government, sir.
May I invite His Excellency Dr. Edgar Lungu to the swearing-in table to officially hand over the instruments of power to the President, Mr. Hakainde Hichilema, the Second President of the Republic of Zambia and Commander-in-Chief of the Defense Force, Your Excellency.
Your Excellencies, visiting heads of state and government, Your Excellencies, special representatives of heads of state and government, Your Excellency, the fourth President of the Republic of Zambia, Mr. Rupia President Banda, and Mrs. Tandiwe Banda, and all the former presidents of respective countries that are present here today. Your Honor, the Vice President of the Republic of Zambia, Mrs. Mutale W.K. Nalumango. Your Honor, the immediate first Vice President of the Republic of Zambia, Madam Inonge Mutukwa Wina, and other former Vice Presidents that are present here. Your Lordship, the Acting Chief Justice, Honorable Justice Michael Musonda. The Speaker of the National Assembly, Honorable Justice Dr. Patrick Matvin. The Chairperson of the Electoral Commission of Zambia, Honorable Judge Isao Chung. The Secretary of the Cabinet, Dr. Simon K. Mitty. Your Worship, the Mayor of the Greater City of Lusaka, MS Chilango Chitangala, and other civic leaders that are present here, newly elected members of Parliament, my lords and lordships, the judges of the Supreme Court, judges of the Constitutional Court, Court of Appeal, and indeed High Court, leaders from the United Party for National Development, UPND Alliance, leaders of political parties that are present, local and international election observers, permanent secretaries, and other senior government officials, Your Excellencies, ambassadors, high commissioners, accredited to the Republic of Zambia, Your Royal Highnesses, members of the clergy, members of the press, fellow Zambians, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Shall I say, fellow Zambians, before we proceed, I request that we take a moment of silence in honor of eminent citizens who passed on this year. And in particular, we lost our founding father and first president of the Republic of Zambia, Dr. Kenneth David Kaunda, and the first female Chief Justice, Madam Irene Mambilima. I also recognize all those that have passed on during this period. I suggest we take a pause for a minute to remember KK, Super Ken, and others. Thank you very much. May their souls rest in eternal peace. My fellow Zambians, 23 years ago, a visionary by the name of Anderson Kambela Mazoka Mwanamuwotu together with his colleagues founded the United Party for National Development, UPND. It was a party founded on the promise of a better Zambia. A Zambia which is united, a Zambia which is prosperous, a Zambia that guarantees basic needs for all our citizens without exception, a Zambia in which the fundamental human rights and property of citizens are protected at all times. Today, we begin our journey towards realizing this dream of that time, which has lived on to now and into the future, I believe. I stand before you today, humbled and filled with gratitude for your trust in a simple village boy who you have made the seventh president of the Republic of Zambia. Thank you so much to all of you Zambians. This victory is not mine, but for all the citizens of our great country, especially the youth who turned out to vote in great numbers with great energy. I shall repeat that. This victory is not mine, but it is for all you, the citizens of our great country, especially the youth of Zambia, who turned out to vote in great numbers, with great energy and passion, and made this day possible. Thank you to the youth of Zambia. We showed the world, the whole world, the resilience of our democracy, and we reaffirm that power belongs to the people of Zambia, not who are elected to serve the people, but the power is deposited in the people of Zambia, not anyone else. And you decide who you want to lead. You, the people of Zambia, resoundingly spoke with your vote, and I thank you from the depth of my heart. The people decided it was time for change. And today, we can boldly say, change is here. The road ahead will not be without challenges, but with a clear vision and a plan which we have, and the relentless determination, we shall overcome and deliver on the aspirations of our people, all of our people. To the jobless youth, a new dawn is here, where you will be skilled and you will find opportunity to work or do business in an economy that will be revived vigorously very soon ahead of us. Very, very soon ahead of us. To the mothers struggling with the high cost of food, the lower cost of living will soon be a reality to all your family members. To the entrepreneur seeking capital, an investor, and a better operating environment is just on the horizon. A government is here that understands your challenges and knows exactly what you need in order to thrive. Very important, extremely important. It is to all our citizens of Zambia truly your moment. Fellow citizens, you have entrusted the UPND and its alliance partners with the responsibility of serving you and running the affairs of this nation with your interest at heart all the time. All the time. We do not take this responsibility lightly. We will truly be your servants, and you, the people, our masters. That's our promise to you. That's our promise to you. As your president, as your servant, I will ensure that we deliver on our promises. Absolutely. Absolutely. We say Bali and the team will fix our economy, but we will do more than just fixing the economy. We will grow our economy so we can lift more people out of poverty than ever before. We will promote unity in diversity and ensure respect for fundamental human rights, liberties, and indeed freedoms for all our people. We will restore the rule of law, general order in our public places and communities, and return our country back to normalcy. Read my lips, no cadrerism from any political party. There is room, there is space for all of you, but there is no space for thuggery, there is no place for violence in the new dawn country of Zambia going forward. Fellow Zambians, I pray that God will continue to guide us throughout our journey. He is our anchor in all seasons. I wish to take this opportunity to thank my colleague, my brother, Mr. Edgar Lungu, our outgoing president, of the Republic of Zambia for his service to this nation and facilitating a smooth transition to our administration from his. We choose not to call it deliberately. Give me your ears. I ask for your attention because this is important. I ask for your attention. We choose not to call this a transfer of power because, as I've already said, power does not belong to us. It belongs to you, the people of Zambia. I think that's important. It is therefore to the great credit of the people of Zambia, people of this nation, that today marks the third peaceful, democratic transfer of leadership since the advent of the multi-party democracy 3 decades ago. This is an historic. This is fundamental to our country and to the region, to our Africa and the global world. This message must be heard and heard clear that democracy is the way to go. Nothing else will work for the people of Zambia and the people of Africa and the world at large, I believe. To my beloved wife Mutinta, words cannot express my gratitude for your unconditional love, your support and counsel over the years. I thank my children and the entire family, many of whom are here somewhere witnessing this historical occasion, for your unwavering support. To my running mate and now Vice President of the Republic of Zambia, Mrs. Mutale Nalumangu, I say thank you for being a part of our vision and being a reliable partner throughout our journey to this day, and I believe going forward. Thank you, madam. I'm confident that together we will deliver to the expectations of the Zambian people. Indeed. Fellow citizens, to all the loyal members of the UPND and its alliance partners and the wider UPND family and the people of Zambia, we are grateful, truly grateful for your contributions towards achieving this day. You worked day and night, traversing all corners of this country to garner the trust of our people under very, very difficult circumstances, extremely restrictive circumstances. Your hard work and commitment have indeed, steered us to victory. I thank you for that. Thank you very much for all your efforts. Nao ngachomeni, na totera sana mkwai, we tumeza huru. Kwa santa lingimane, na taija, na salija, ziko mkwandiri, tunasa kilingimane. Kwa santi la chituma mwani, ndalu magapati. We commend the Electoral Commission of Zambia for the enduring, for ensuring, under very difficult circumstances, that the elections were successfully held despite the ravaging COVID-19 pandemic and other challenges that we believe will be a thing of the past as we move towards a truly independent Electoral Commission to deliver free, fair, credible elections all the years ahead. I wish to thank and commend all political parties and individuals who participated in the election. Your participation makes our multi-party democracy stronger. To you, competitors, we pledge a better democracy where your voices and fundamental human rights, liberties and freedoms will be exercised without restriction from our government. Mark my words. You will have your freedom. You deserve your freedom. It is entitled, you are born with it. To the church, we thank you for your prayers and guidance before, during, and after elections. To our traditional leaders, your wise and invaluable counsel is much appreciated. To To our cooperating partners, we sincerely thank you for the material and financial support towards these elections and indeed other programs that have helped to enhance the betterment of the lives of our people. You once again have demonstrated true friendship to the people of Zambia. To the various stakeholders, particularly the election observers and the media, both local and international, we thank you for the role you played in these elections. Fellow Zambians, as we embark on a term of office as presidents of this great Republic of Zambia, we shall abide by the vision of our party to have a united, prosperous, and equitable Zambia. I therefore invite every Zambian to join hands with us as we move forward on this noble journey. I invite the private sector on this journey, and I'm particular about this because you have a great role to play to help grow the economy. Zambia Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Zambia Chamber of Mines, Zambia Association of Manufacturers, the Zambia National Farmers Union, the Zambia Federation of Employers, Labour Movement, the Tourism Council of Zambia, and others. I invite you all to work with us in unison to deliver for the people of Zambia. Let us all get better organized so we can deliver better lives for all our people in our various responsibilities. I invite all political parties to work with us within the remits of a democratic society. We must put aside our election-related and other differences and pull in one direction as a country, as a people. We have a lot more things that unite us than those that divide us, I believe. We must devote our energies to contribute meaningfully to the national development of our country, all of our country, 10 provinces of our country. I invite the church and the traditional leaders to continue providing spiritual, moral guidance and to be true partners in development in pursuit of better lives for all our people. I invite the civil society to continue complementing our development efforts. I invite our development partners to continue your cooperation as Zambia's recovery requires concerted effort given our current difficult situation economically and socially. Going forward, you will see rationality from us. You will see prudence, effectiveness from our side. Fellow Zambians, our focus over the next 5 years will be on restoring macroeconomic stability and promoting growth of the economy, because we know what this brings. We will pay special attention to lowering the fiscal deficit, reducing public debt, and restoring social and market confidence in our country. We will also promote national unity and good governance by strict adherence to the rule of law. Very important. We will focus on inclusion and not exclusion. Unity and not divisions, gathering and not scattering our people. Fellow Zambians, economic management is very important. Over the last decade, we have witnessed the erosion of our economy. The debt situation has become unsustainable, reducing the country's capacity to invest in productive areas of our economy and addressing the gaps in the healthcare services, education, and other social services. We must restore this situation. Our national budget has been overwhelmed by debt services, emoluments, and consumption when there should be no, if you like, room for this, because the greater room that exists should be for investment, it should be for growth, not to consume and to ensure continued wasting. Not good for us, not good for our children. The high levels of unemployment, especially among our youth, is of great concern to us, and this will be high on our agenda to address. Food should be available and affordable for all our people, at least 3 decent meals each day. This is important to our people. important to us, and we wish to deliver that.
The people have hope and expect us to address the cost of living that is beyond the reach of the majority of our citizens. The scourge of corruption has not only eroded our much-needed resources, but it has also robbed us of the opportunity for growth, for job creation, business, health services, and the list is long. We shall have zero tolerance to corruption. Shall I repeat that? We shall have zero tolerance to corruption. This will be our hallmark. The fight against corruption will be professional. It will not be vindictive. We will not be going out there for retribution or vengeance. That is not for us. That's not for us. The institutions, however, mandated to investigate and prosecute will be given unfettered autonomy to effectively and efficiently carry out their mandate without fear or favor of political bias. That's our promise. That's our promise. We are determined to free our country from the evils of mismanagement and malpractice and promote that which is best for all our people. We will undertake an ambitious economic, social transformation agenda to move Zambia forward, to create equitable opportunities for all our people and to reduce poverty. Very important. We believe that the time will come when poverty in our country will not be tolerated, and those days are coming very soon. No Zambian should go to bed hungry, as I've said already. No effort should be spared in salvaging the children, our children, from the streets, or those that are engaged in vices such as alcohol and unsustainable, unacceptable abuse of different substances. We are coming to offer help to you, our children. Our administration will also prioritize establishing a safe and predictable environment that will promote private, local, regional, and international investment. International investment working with, I want to be understood here, investment local, investment regional. We must look at as Africa to have joint investments across our country boundaries before we think of Europe, before we think of Asia, before we think of America. That will increase the bondage, that will maximize benefits that stay in our countries and within the continent. Very important. Very, very important. But obviously we shall work to access investment from countries elsewhere because they have a larger savings pool than ourselves as we create capacity within our own economy and on the continent. We will aggressively promote the creation of jobs and opportunities that will create wealth, especially for our youth and indeed our citizens. I'm a firm believer that we may be good-hearted, we may like to share, but we cannot share poverty. We have to create value so we can redistribute. This is a fundamental philosophical belief for us. God has blessed us with abundant natural resources, human and other resources that will be applied to derive greater value for, through value creation and indeed to promote greater supply chain participation by our citizens. Unless our citizens participate in this process, we will create a sense of alienation and no one will be safe in such an environment. We are intertwined, we can share common benefits, common value from the process of development. That is possible. It just needs a clever and smart way of mixing it up, and we'll do that for the people of Zambia. Fellow Zambians, some of our key priority sectors that will drive economic growth and reduce poverty are agriculture, mining, energy, financial services, tourism, technology, health and education. In agriculture, we will work to enhance production, agriculture extension services, market access, value addition, and lowering the cost of inputs, the cost of production, in what we shall soon call a broader agricultural support program. Very broad indeed to cover all areas of agriculture. And we know the benefits that will be derived from there. We are sure of that. We understand that area very well. We shall promote expansion of the mining value chain as well as the promotion of mineral diversification. We will therefore encourage the production, processing of gemstones, gold, nickel, manganese, iron and industrial and other minerals. We will put in place measures to facilitate local ownership. You have heard me. We will put in place measures to facilitate local ownership and increase participation of Zambians in this important sector. Recognizing the importance of energy for development and our administration, therefore, we will transform Zambia into an energy surplus country. For our people, of course, we need energy. We also will produce energy for the neighboring countries, because God gave us unparalleled natural endowment that will allow us to produce surplus energy. We will therefore implement an ambitious energy investment plan to increase power generation and better broaden the energy mix. In addition, we will put in place a conducive economic environment to encourage private sector investment in generation, transmission, distribution, and indeed retail, to allow our young people, our youth, to be entrepreneurs at an early age. I know how that works. It is beneficial to us as citizens and to our young family, so that they can take care of the future. Fellow Zambians, to improve land administration and management in the country, our administration will put in place a transparent policy framework for land administration. We will promote equitable access to land for all citizens. We will strengthen the land tenure security and enhance sustainable utilization and productive management of our land resources. Very, very important for progress to be achieved. The potential of the tourism sector will soon be realized. Of course, we understand the current COVID situation, but we must be ready to take off in tourism once COVID is brought under control, which we will as a government, as a service unit in the people planet. And therefore, tourism and its various endowments as a destination of choice will be realized. This will include reviewing our visa requirements, making them simple for tourists to access our tourist resorts and other benefits, building support infrastructure and revisiting tax rates in the sector. Economic cooperation, trade investment, security, peace and stability and development will form a critical base for our foreign bodies. I shall repeat that. For obvious reasons. Economic cooperation, trade and investment, security for peace and stability for development will form a critical base for our foreign policy within our neighborhood in Africa and on the global stage. Very important shift from what is going on at the moment, because we know the value of that. So please, let's not be misunderstood. There are a little bit of misunderstanding that this democratic delivery, dramatic delivery, may be something which is not, but it's a positive development. And it is no threat to anybody in the region or elsewhere. So you choose your own leaders, as Zambians choose their own leaders, as they be on the top of August this year. National unity. Fellow Zambians, I want to assure the nation that under our administration, the one Zambia, one nation motto shall be our way of life. We are indeed one Zambia, one people, regardless of your race or ethnicity. We have no tolerance for any form of discrimination, and we commit to ensuring our government will be a reflection of our 10 provinces. Just wait a while, see when we announce the cabinet, you'll be very proud of us, because the cabinet will be inclusive and will have members from all the 10 provinces of the country. We treat diversity as a strength. Never again should any difference be used for political mileage or to favor one over another. Not at all. Every citizen will be availed equal opportunity to participate in the social economic development of our nation. We will not be selective when it comes to the development of our country. All regions will have an equitable share of investment because they deserve it. That's why they elected us in office. with such a strong mandate under very difficult circumstances. Good governance and the rule of law are very important. They are very important ingredients to development. The UPND Alliance Government Administration will enhance good governance and simply uphold the rule of law. As I said already, we will live up to our campaign promises by ensuring that all citizens are equal before the law. All citizens are equal before the law, without exception. Absolutely. None, anything close to animal farm, but we need proper equity, proper equality before the law. We in the executive should not interfere in the work of other arms of government. Our constitution provides for separation of powers of these arms of government, and we will therefore endeavor to promote this principle in order to enhance good governance in our country. And hopefully that will have an impact in the region in a small way and in the global community. Coordination to deliver for our people will, however, be of critical importance, because these two arms of government, and I shall indicate, including the vision, need to coordinate, need to have a shared vision to better the lives of our people. So coordination will be important and it is done. Fellow citizens, it's a new dawn. Fellow citizens, it is a new dawn. The fourth estate, as I said, the media will be free. For you, the media, you will be truly free. You will operate independently without looking over your shoulder. Who is tear gassing you? Who is shutting down your radio station? Who is shutting down your television station? Because you say something that we do not know. There is nothing that we do not know. It's your role to self-regulate. It is your role to report fairly, responsibly, so you can build this society to be at a level never seen before. That's your responsibility. Responsibility comes with obligation. Sort out the leaks amongst yourselves, but you have the freedom to do it. Time has come for all Zambians to be truly free. I believe after the 12th of August, you have gone to bed feeling free, feeling safe. There will be more higher sense of safety as we proceed. That's our commitment to you. I want to reiterate what I said during my acceptance address, that gone are the days when political cadres would take over the functions of a public service worker in a market, in a bathroom, in a government office, and other places. Absolutely never again. Never again. Our administration will not allow such disorder, because you cannot grow the economy, you cannot create jobs, you cannot not offer business opportunities in a disorderly manner like that, where people are afraid even to get to a bus stop, to jump on a bus, to go to visit a cousin, an uncle, or a nephew. You are free to use bus stops. You are free to trade in the market. You are free to do that which you wish, of course, knowing that where your freedom ends, someone else's freedom starts. That's the way it shall be going forward. Our administration will ensure that sanity returns to all our places, all our communities. The days of government workers being retired in national interest for political or unfair grounds are over, completely over, because you are entitled to a job in the public service. It doesn't matter where you are born, it doesn't matter who your mother, your father is, because you did not choose. That is a natural phenomenon, it is an occasion that is determined by God and God only. So you will not be victimized for that reason. So those that were victimized along these lines, please provide the information, prepare to return to your way, because you deserve to be victimized. The days of political interference in public institutions and parastatals are over. Fellow citizens, with regards to education, we will pursue policies that will address the core barriers of access to education, because the economy needs skills. We don't see you giving you education as a favor. we see it as a bare minimum, and education is the best investment for any child. I'm an example of that. And we shall offer that opportunity to others too, without exception, when they need all the time. We will also ensure that established standards for quality education are met and enforced. In addition, we will enhance linkages between education and industry to ensure graduates have relevant and employable skills. Indeed, skills that would also enable such young people to work for themselves as entrepreneurs at an early age. It is possible. We will assist you to realize this possibility. Further, we will promote innovation, entrepreneurship for job and wealth creation. Fellow Zambians, to realize these aspirations in a systematic manner, our administration will develop and implement rationalized, succinct, and actionable plans. We are not for big documents. We are for documents that are action-oriented, documents that will allow us to move forward rapidly in bringing about development of country. These plans will focus on achieving economic transformation, entrepreneurship, development, digital revolution, with jobs and business opportunities to top on our agenda. The plan will also incorporate other measures critical to the attainment of our national vision towards being rapidly over time to a middle-income country ahead of us. Fellow Zambians, to achieve the Zambia we have dreamt of for years, we must work together as a people. People united in diversity. And our motto of one Zambia, one nation, as I have said already. This is what our founding father, Super Ken, KK, Dr. Kaunda, believed in. To achieve the Zambia we dreamt of, we need to be committed to hard work. With hard work, patriotism, discipline, and dedication, we will achieve and attain our national aspirations. We must be innovative and identify local solutions to address our problem. Indeed, solutions, if not found in Zambia, are found in SADC, are found on the African continent, and we should work together in that manner before we reach out across the seas. I think that's logical. We must be open to new ideas. As your government, we will make available. We will listen. We will support you. We will get your advice and we will value it. We must ensure environmental sustainability, inclusiveness in our development agenda. We must mitigate against climate change and strive to build a green economy. We must respect, promote, and protect the rights of one another. Fellow Zambians, the defense and protection of the Constitution of Zambia is critical to the realization of our development agenda. Equally important is the respect for culture and heritage. We need ethical and servant leadership at all levels of society. We need morality, integrity, and indeed accountability. Fellow Zambians, under our administration, our country will continue to be an active member of regional, continental, and international bodies. We are committed to enhancing international cooperation and foreign relations. We are committed to promoting open and cordial relations with our neighbors and countries on the continent and indeed beyond. We are equally committed to ensuring a foreign policy based on mutual interests and respect. But as I said earlier on, economic diplomacy will touch center stage so we can alleviate poverty of our people in this country, in the region, Africa as a whole, and of course the world. Fellow Zambians, I stand before you and with you as the president and as a true servant. President devoted to take our country to greater heights. I pledge a better Zambia for all our people. God bless us all. God bless our democracy. God bless our great republic of Zambia. God bless Africa and our global family. I thank you.
May I take this opportunity to invite the President, Mr. Hakainde Hichilema, the 7th President of the Republic of Zambia and Commander-in-Chief of the Defense Force, to walk down and release the balloons. Mr. President, sir.